بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد المبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
It is a pleasure and an honor for me to have been invited into the Jamia Masjid to deliver the Jummah Khutbah. As you know, I have been delivering a few speeches in the past few days and will continue in the next few days. May Allah Azza wa Jal accept my attendance and your attendance in any gathering, whether it be the Jummah prayer or any Milad al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathering. As you know, we have entered the month of Rabiul Awwal, and as the chairman of the Masjid has just mentioned, that we have been having regular gatherings on Maulid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is the month in which the believers rejoice. It is the month in which the believers celebrate the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But in reality, we can never do justice to his praise. We can never honor the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the manner in which he deserves to be honored. And this has been summarized by a poet in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose name was Hassan bin Thabit, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The famous poet who used to sing praises in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions this. He says, مَا مَدَحْتُ مُحَمَّدًا بِمَقَالَتِي وَلَكِن مَدَحْتُ مَقَالَتِي بِمُحَمَّدٍ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, this is Sahabi, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, I can't praise Muhammad with my words, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but rather my words are made praiseworthy by the mention of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in reality, there's nothing we can do to do justice to his rank, his praise and his honor, but we speak about him in the hope that he honors us, in the hope that he intercedes for us on the Day of Judgment, in the hope that we become beloved to him. He is already beloved to Allah Azza wa Jal. He does not need us, we need him. So the objective of spending time praising the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and spending time in gatherings of Maulid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are ultimately to attain his pleasure sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is something I will speak about this evening. But today's topic, which I have been asked to speak about, is why is it necessary to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? But there's a question before this one. Why is it necessary to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The question is, firstly, what does it mean for something to be beloved to you? What does it mean for you to be in love with something or someone? We all live in the dunya, many of us go to work, many of us earn money, many of us, in fact all of us, have parents, whether they are living or are passed away. Many of us have children, brothers and sisters, and many of the things in the dunya are dear to us. But when we say something is beloved or dear, what does that actually mean? What that means is that it is close to our hearts. It is close to our hearts. So if I say, I love my children, I am effectively saying, my children are close to my heart. If I say, I love wealth, that means wealth is close to my heart. If I say, I love my parents, that means my parents are close to my heart. And if we say, I love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that means the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is close to my heart. That is the overall objective, to say that the last thing. But what are the signs of love? If it's easy for me to say I love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it's also easy for me to say that I love my children, I love my parents, I love this, I love that. But ultimately that love will be manifested in action. When I say I love my children, that is easy to prove. The proof of that is I spend all of my time with my children. I do anything I can to please my children. I do everything I can to make them happy. Their happiness is my happiness. If they are sad, I am sad. Right? So it's, we see in terms of things in the dunya, things which are beloved to us, it is clear from our behavior. If we love money, you will see that a person will do everything to gain that money. You will sacrifice everything for the sake of a few TT. Right? Doesn't matter if he has what morals. It doesn't matter if he cheats somebody. It doesn't matter if he has to kill somebody. As long as he gets what's beloved to him, he will sacrifice whatever it takes. These are signs of love. Another sign is, we make mention of those things which are beloved to us. So if I always talk about money, I sit down with you, I say, or if I spend this Jumu'ah khutbah saying about how to make money, if I say money is great, money is this, money is that, do what you can to make money, it is a sign that I actually love money. If all I talk about is my children to you, and all I think about are my children, that is a sign that I love my children. But really, the topic of this discussion now, with this framework in mind about what is love and what are the signs of love, in a few moments I have summarized this. Now think, the love of the Prophet ﷺ is integral to our faith. It is fundamental to our faith. It is the foundation of our faith. We cannot complete our faith without loving the Prophet ﷺ. But it is important to bear in mind that when we say love the Prophet ﷺ, it is not ordinary love that we need. It is not love for our parents. It is not the same as love for our children. The Prophet ﷺ has clearly mentioned in the hadith, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ وَالِدِهِ وَوَالَدِهِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. Very famous hadith. That none of you will truly believe. None of you will complete your faith. You will not be complete believers in Allah and the Prophet ﷺ until I am more beloved to you than your parents, than your children, and all of mankind. Now this hadith is absolutely fascinating because it came from the one who is Sadiq wa Masduq, who is absolutely truthful. Everything he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is 100% true. Do we believe this? Yes. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam words to the effect of, I need to be more beloved to you than everything else, including your own self. But bearing the signs of love that I have just mentioned, we have to ask ourselves, is this actually the case? Is it actually the case that we love the Prophet ﷺ more than our parents? Is it actually the case that we love the Messenger of Allah ﷺ more than our children? And is it the case that we love the Prophet ﷺ more than ourselves? Now, if we want to answer these questions for ourselves, we must go back to the signs of love. Because one can say, well, look, I'm not sure. I love my children, but I love the Messenger of Allah. I love my parents, but I love the Messenger of Allah. I love myself, but I also love the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's special, isn't it? You can't always gauge love. It's not like mathematics. If you love this person, you don't. Or opposites. It's not one or the other. Love is an emotion. It's hard to gauge. So how can we gauge if we have truly loved the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more than everything else? The questions to think about and ask ourselves are, how much do I think about my children? And how much do I think about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How much do I think about my parents? And how much do I think about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How much would I serve my mother? And what would I do for my mother? Under whose feet Jannah lies, who we are told to honor and to not even say oof to. What would I do for my beloved mother or my beloved father? And what would I do for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What would I do for myself? How much effort and time we take to gratify ourselves, to please ourselves, to make sure we are happy. Everybody wants happiness. We sacrifice everything to ensure we are happy. As long as I am happy, I want a good job. I will spend all of my time making sure that I have ease in the dunya. What makes you do that for yourself is your love for yourself. This is not wrong. These things are not wrong. I'm not saying you mustn't love your children. Of course, we love our children. I'm not saying we must not love our parents. Of course, we love our parents. But the Prophet ﷺ is more dear to the believers than themselves. And we cannot complete our faith until this is the case. So we must train ourselves, teach ourselves how to increase in love for the Prophet ﷺ. And time does not permit to go into how to increase the love and how to act on this hadith, but in summary form, increase in your salawat, increase in learning about him ﷺ, do his remembrance, learn about his sunnah, learn about his seerah. These are ways to make you fall in love with the Prophet ﷺ, actually falling in love to the extent that you can't think about anybody but him ﷺ. That was what the Sahaba were like. Say, may my father and mother be sacrificed for you, Ya Rasulullah. This is a phrase that you find in all books of hadith. Say, may my father and mother be sacrificed for you. This is the love of the Sahaba. So it can be done. And people after the Sahaba, who never saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, also had this love. But this is what we must do, and why we should love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because our faith cannot be complete without it. And as the Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, just to elaborate on that fact further, he once said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "La anta ahabu ilayya min kulli shay illa al-masjid." He said, "Ya Rasulullah, indeed you are more beloved to me. Look at the honesty, look at the relationship he had with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." He said, "Ya Rasulullah, you are more beloved to me min kulli shay, more beloved than everything, illa nafsi, except myself." This is Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Look at the honesty. Says, "I love you, Ya Rasulullah, but you know what? I actually love myself more." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Nah, no." And he took an oath by Allah Azza wa Jal, in whose hand is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's soul, that you cannot complete your faith until I am more beloved to you than your nafs, than yourself. After hearing this and understanding this, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, then he said, "You are more beloved to me than myself, Ya Rasulullah." And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Al-an Umar, Ya Umar." He said, "Now Umar, you have completed your faith. Now Umar, you are truly a believer." So these are things that we have to bear in mind, especially in the month of Rabi'ul Awwal. The objective here is to increase in our love, to complete our faith, to ensure that we follow and emulate him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then in another hadith about love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again giving a reason why we should love him, why we have to love him, is the following. The famous hadith that somebody asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "When is the Day of Judgment?" He said, "What have you prepared for it?" He said, "La shay." He said, "Nothing. Illa anni uhibbu Allah wa rasoola," except I love Allah and His Rasul more than anything else, in brackets. So he asked, "When is the Day of Judgment?" The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him a kind of question, not denying or affirming his knowledge. He has knowledge of when the Day of Judgment is. But what's more important than finding out the day of the day of judgment is, what have you prepared? This is a lesson for us. Many of us want to hear about the end of times, the day of judgment, and all of these things. But the important question is, what have we prepared? And this man said nothing, except actually the biggest thing of all, that I love Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say after? أَنْتَ مَعَا مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. He said, you will be with the one you love. If we ever had a reason for loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is summarized in that response. Love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will lead us to being with him on the Day of Judgment. The Day of Judgment, when Allah's ghadab, his anger, will be like never before, when the sun will be a mile above our heads, people will be sweating and perspiring and drowning in their sweat according to their actions. And on that Day of Judgment, when there's no shade except His shade, Allah's shade, He will shade certain categories of people. We will go from prophet to prophet, asking them to intercede for us. And they will say, not today. They will say, not for me. I can't help you. Until we go to the Prophet and we beseech, we ask, we beg the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for his intercession on that day when there is no shade except Allah's shade, and when Allah's ghadab is like never before, and when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intercedes for us, then we will be able to move forward in the Day of Judgment, and his intercession again will lead people into Jannah. Naturally, he will intercede for those who he loves. He will intercede for Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, for the Sahaba Ikram, for the Awliya Ikram, the righteous predecessors who acted on this hadith, who perfected their faith. We have to train ourselves to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our hearts, so that we will be with him on the Day of Judgment. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turns away from us on that day, right? This is a very serious thought about which we have to reflect upon. The question really is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happy with me? Do I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do I truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because if the answer is no, and we are found out on the Day of Judgment that actually we didn't really love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he's not pleased with our endeavors, what happens if he turns away from us? What happens if he does not intercede for us? What happens if we are left to face Allah azza wa jal without the protection of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That person who does not have the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is finished. Literally, absolutely finished. Because if Allah deals with us through His justice, we will certainly go down. But if we have the shade of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is actually our only hope. And in the grave we know that there are three questions. What are the questions? Man Rabbuka? Who is your Lord? Ma Dinuk? What is your religion? مَا كُنْتَ تَقُولُ فِي حَقِّ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ. The final question, the second question is, what is your religion? The third question is, what did you used to say about this man? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be there. Imagine, those who love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those who sacrifice their time for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those who always used to think about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people who always said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, duruj constantly, those who organized the Mawlid gatherings, those who attended the Mawlid gatherings, those who participated in the Milad Sharif for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be able to answer that question, and that is the final question in the grave. If you answer that question correctly, the window to Jannah will be open for you. The grave will be open for you. and you will be able to roam in the realm of the souls. Now think about these three questions in the final couple of minutes. It's like a sieve. I think of these questions like a sieve, metaphorically speaking. You know, like a sieve, when you put something in there and you shake it, the substance comes out that you want, it purifies it, doesn't it? Now the first question is, Manurabu, who is your Lord? Those who say anything other than Allah failed at the first hurdle. Polytheists, mushrikeen, will fail at the first hurdle. But what about Christians and Jews? They believe in, well, classically believed in, monotheistic God. So they may answer that question. They might say, Allah, God is another name for Allah. Then the next question is, what is your religion? That is when those people living now who say other than Islam, they fall at the second hurdle. But we know there are many divisions in Islam, unfortunately, sects. So they will all say Islam. The defining question which will determine whether we are successful or fail in the grave revolves and depends on the final question about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who said that there's another prophet after him, they will fail. Those who had hatred in their heart for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will fail. Those who prioritize other things and the dunya and the world and wealth and the pleasures in the dunya that we see, those who prioritize those things and neglected their rights to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will fail at that question. Only the true believers who truly love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be able to answer that question correctly. So we have to make it through these questions. Our salvation depends upon it. So in conclusion, I will say to you, as you will have heard, reflect on who is beloved to you, why they are beloved to you, and then reflect on whether the signs of love are there for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are they there in you? Do you talk about him enough? Do you think about him enough? Do you emulate him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enough? If the answer is no, it's something we have to work on. We have to work on to complete our faith. May Allah azza wa jalla give us all the ability to understand and act upon what we have said. Give us all true love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and for us to appreciate why it is so integral to our faith. Ameen wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And alhamdulillah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La